So, welcome everyone to the second GcMaf Immunology Conference in this year, 2013. And thank you all very much for coming, especially those who have travelled from places as far away as the USA, Brazil, Kazakhstan, India, Sweden, and Australia. And it's very good to see familiar faces. We at ImmunoBiotech are very proud to be sponsoring this conference, which we said would be an annual event, unless discoveries ran so fast we had to do another conference earlier. Well, they have run very fast indeed, as you will see from the speakers. So this is the second conference in 2013, and the next venue will probably be Switzerland or Turkey, probably in October 2014. I'd now like to introduce you to the man who decided this conference would be in Dubai, Professor Marco Ruggiero, MD, who is a medical doctor, a radiologist, a full professor of molecular biology at the University of Florence, and our newly appointed scientific director. Marco.
Good morning to everyone, and thank you for being here. And I wish to start my presentation by thanking, first of all the people from the Dubai area who invited us to be here, all the guests from this area, and Mr. David Knox for having made this possible. It is thanks to his vision, his courage, his persistence that this conference and this entire enterprise has been possible. Now, in this conference, you will see scientists and medical doctors presenting results on the effect of GcMaf in the immunotherapy of a variety of diseases. You know, and let's talk about the effects of GcMaf in advanced cancer patients. Why advanced cancer patients? Well, the answer is easy. As the speaker before me said, this type of treatment usually comes after other treatments have been tried or after other treatments have failed. This didn't happen in the times of William Colley at the end of the 19th century for the very simple reason that there were no other treatments available for cancer, and cancer was diagnosed by bare hands or naked eyes only when it was advanced. So we're now back in the situation where William Colley was. This paper has been published in the journal named Oncoimmunology, so the title, the name of the journal tells you what is the journal about. And this particular paper on GcMaf, on the effects of GcMaf on amylase in advanced cancer patients, was thought to be so important by the editors of the journal that they wanted to put the molecular structure of GcMaf in the front cover. Again, for scientists, for the vanity of scientists, this is a kind of important achievement as to be on the cover of Time for a businessman or for a politician. Talking about the effects of GcMaf on advanced cancer, we have to mention the very first paper describing those effects that was published in the International Journal of Cancer in 2007 by the research group of Professor Yamamoto, where he described the eradication, he used that noun, the eradication of metastatic breast cancer with GcMaf. But I will not talk about this paper now. I wish to focus your attention on the paper that is reported below. And I will talk now, because when I will show you the slides just in a few minutes, you will not be listening to my words any longer. So let me tell you what did these scientists from Japan do. First of all, this research group from Japan has nothing to do with Professor Yamamoto. They worked in Japan completely independently. And as you know, in science, when you achieve results, the same results by two independent groups, this gives much more credibility to whatever results are presented. I wish to draw your attention on the institution where these scientists come from. You may recognize the Atomic Bomb Institute in Nagasaki. one of the most prestigious for, of course, dramatic reasons, research institutions in cancer from all over the world. You know what happened in Nagasaki in 1945. Because of that, all top cancer scientists went there and still there observing the effects of ionizing radiations released by the atomic bomb on human population. So we're talking about the most prestigious oncologic institutions in the world. These scientists, what did they do? They simply transplanted into receptive mice a human tumor, hepatocellular carcinoma, and they let the tumor grow. Then they divided the mice into groups. In one group, they did not do anything, and in the other group, they administered subcutaneously GcMaf for 3 weeks, every day for 3 weeks. I think that the next slide doesn't need any explanation on my part. You can see by yourself, here we're not talking about fancy tumor markers. We are not showing graphs or histograms. Here we are showing real tumors. And you can read that in the, you can see that in the non-treatment group, this is the size of the tumor. In the treatment group, if you go by volume, you have a 90% reduction of the size of the real tumor in 3 weeks of daily subcutaneous injection of GcMaf. I think this is pretty dramatic. This comes from a completely independent research group. So I think that you cannot but believe your eyes when you see these tumors. If you look at the quantity, they injected 40 nanograms per kilogram per day. In a human, this would be equivalent to 2,800 nanograms per day. Definitely much more of the original indication put forward by Professor Yamamoto, who suggested to inject 100 nanograms per week. So here we will have to discuss about quantities and activities. So these are the results obtained with a human tumor transplanted in mice in Japan. And now we move to Switzerland, where, as Mr. Knox said, we have our treatment center. And again, this has been possible thanks to the courage, the vision, and the persistence of Mr. Knox. And here we can see patients, we can treat patients with the new molecules of GcMaf, but later on I will explain why they are more potent. There is a reason. As Mr. Knox said, I have a double affiliation. I am a clinical radiologist, and in addition, I am a professor of molecular biology. So here I'm talking as a clinical radiologist with a specialization in ultrasonography. I don't know if you can see anything. Most likely the light is not the most appropriate. We radiologists, we like to live in the dark. But this is a breast cancer patient, a very nice lady, age 60 or 61, stage 3 cancer with no metastasis. You should be able to see that the cancer has a triangular shape here. This is the skin of the patient. This is the pectoralis muscle. And here we take measurement with the ultrasonography. We use the ultrasonography system to inject the GcMaf very, very close to the tumor, as close as possible to the tumor. And then we take measurement, and this is much worse. And after 2 weeks, we see a decrease in length of the tumor taking this side from 179 to 136 centimeters. I must tell you that this advanced and sophisticated ultrasound equipment is able to discriminate 1/10 of a millimeter. So we can be as precise as to go down to 1/10 of a millimeter. This other lady had stage 4, or maybe more than that if there was some other stage beyond the 4, of pancreatic carcinoma that had spread all over her abdomen. So she had a peritoneal carcinosis with acidic fluid, and she was in terrible pain. Now, following the suggestion of a colleague of mine, Dr. Jeff Presley, to also is injecting GcMaf directly into the peritoneum, into the acidic fluid in other patients with other types of cancer. We did the same, and we could not measure here the size of the tumor for the very simple reason that the tumor was so spread that we could not find an area that we could measure reliably and then say that it is reduced, it is shrunk or what. But we could measure the acidic fluid. In ultrasonography, acidic fluid is black. So here you have the right kidney, and all this black area here is acidic fluid. 2 weeks later, same kidney, and you see that the acidic fluid is much less. Then you go left, this is the left kidney, this is the spleen, this is the acidic fluid here, and you can see 2 weeks later, no more acidic fluid is present there. Of course, the lady is feeling much better, much less pain, and she's struggling, she's striving to fight against this cancer, when in her home country, she was given just a few days to live. And we think she has much more than a few days to live after this treatment that, of course, is combined with the nutritional plan and with all the other complementary therapies that Mr. Knox just told you about. Now, in my opinion, and considering the latest results that we have had, all the papers that have been published by 100 and some scientists for the past 20 years, there is no doubt that GcMaf is very powerful against cancer. Now we have to try to understand why is GcMaf so powerful against cancer and why the so-called new GcMaf is about 200-fold more potent than the old one. Well, we and others recently demonstrated that GcMaf, at variance with what Professor Yamamoto had hypothesized 20 years ago, has many more effects in addition to stimulating the immune system that then in turn will attack and destroy the cancer cells. Because we and others demonstrated that GcMaf directly inhibits cancer cell proliferation and it reverts the neoplastic phenotype. To make it short, it makes cancer cells to become normal. It also inhibits cancer cells induced angiogenesis. I will explain what this term means. And of course, it stimulates macrophages that will kill cancer cells. Here we have human breast cancer cells, and we were looking for vimentin expression. What is vimentin? It is a protein that it is expressed, that means it is present, when cells become more malignant. It is called epithelial mesenchymal transition. So when cancer cells become more malignant, they have a greater potential for metastasis, they express this protein. Here you can see that we exposed the cells for 3 days to 40 nanograms, please remember this number, 40 nanograms of GcMaf, and we saw a significant effect on the expression of vimentin. That is a reversion, inhibition of vimentin expression. So this meant that these cells tended to become normal. Why I want you to focus on the 40 nanograms? Because 2 years later, that is just a few months ago, we did the same experiment, but this time with a new GcMaf that we called Goleic or GcMaf oleic acid. And here, I show you, just as I did before, the entire plate. So I do not like to select one particular region of interest. I could have selected this region filled with cancer cells and this region completely void of cancer cells. I don't like to do this. So I show you the entire petri dish. In the upper panel, you see the human breast cancer cells growing like men and trying to fill every space in the petri dish. If you treat this with 0.2 nanograms, it is 200-fold less GcMaf oleic acid after 24 hours instead of 72 as seen before, you can judge by yourself. You still see a few cancer cells, but I think that there is no need for any sophisticated analysis of images to visually assess that there has been a strong inhibition of cancer cell proliferation and induction of cancer cell apoptosis. So now this is why we can say that the new GcMaf molecules, which are more physiologic, they are about 200-fold more potent than the old ones, at least in vitro. But I think that this is interesting, and I think you will notice that this is the big cancer cell. You see these two macrophages? They are deconstructing, destroying the cytoplasm of the cancer cell here. You can see this very well. But you can also appreciate the same action of this destruction of the cytoplasm here, and less evident here, but also here. Also here you can see that the shape of the cytoplasm of the cancer cells is actively destroyed by this macrophage with its cytoplasm fully vacuolized. It is working, destroying the cancer cell. Here you can see two cancer cells, one is this one and this one, attacked by a number of macrophages. This one is in the middle, is fighting two enemies at the same time. But this one has already attached to the cytoplasm of the cancer cell. This one here is destroying this part of this cancer cell, and this is coming to the rescue, is about to come and attack this cancer cell from this side. And all these others, they are coming and they are destroying these cancer cells. Again, you will see much nicer movies of this, of what is happening, thanks to the work of Dr. Rod Smith later on. This is another clinical case. This guy had liver metastasis, this big, that they did not fit the field of the ultrasonography machine. So this is a liver metastasis of about 12 centimeters. About 80% of his liver was substituted for by metastasis. This picture was taken 1 year after GcMaf treatment, conjugated with a very severe nutritional plan, very severe and very strict exercise plan. So this guy did everything correctly, and 1 year after, the metastasis was still there. It was quite disappointing. But with the ultrasonography and then with MRI, I was able to demonstrate that this was no longer a growing metastasis, this was scar tissue. For those of you who are familiar with ultrasonography, and those who are not, may come to the course so that we can teach them some tricks. All this white appearance of this metastasis indicates that this is no longer a growing tumor. You may remember that the growing tumors that I showed you before were black, up to the point that you didn't see them. This is white. White means fibrous tissue, and you may recognize a capsule. Here, this is a regular liver, normal liver, and this is the capsule surrounding the metastasis. So, is this eradication? Well, you decide. There are no longer growing tumor cells, there is a scar tissue, which is 12 centimeters in length, so unless you are a skilled radiologist, you may think that the metastasis has remained there, but the guy would not have been alive with a metastasis of 12 centimeters lasting for more than 1 year, so this is most important. And actually, this is no longer a growing tumor, this is scar tissue. So when you talk about eradication, you always have to define the terms of what you are talking about. I thank you for your patience and your attention.